Hey guys, welcome to a special edition of Show Me Your Tech. I'm your host, KoolKard. Now, I'm going to do a little something different today. Normally, I get out in the streets and I run up on random people and I want to see what's in their bags, what's in their pockets, what type of tech they're carrying around because everybody has a device on them. But today, we're going to pinpoint and highlight one individual, one person who has many hats and a lot of gadgets. So we're going to dig into his bag of gadgets, see what type of devices he likes and what he prefers and what his favorites are. And we're going to highlight the cameras today because he has a couple of them and some good ones. So without further ado, my man, Dajour Ashwood.
What's going on?
Oh,
happy to
man.
Be here. Happy to be here.
Thank you. Thank you for coming on here, showing and sharing all your little tech devices you have.
Absolutely.
And that,
absolutely.
And that ain't little.
Yeah, with my little Canon right here.
Yes, 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 indeed. Mm-hmm. Just give us a rundown, you know, on what you do,
sure.
What you're into, and then we'll get into those beauties that you got right there.
All right, real quickly, first and foremost, I'm an actor and here in Atlanta, originally from Harlem. And outside of acting, I do a lot of self-taping for other actors. And I also have a production called Make a Film in 8 Hours, which is absolutely fabulous.
Yes, indeed.
And it's catered for filmmakers, editors, and also actors to basically come and make a film in a matter of just 8 hours.
Matter of 8 hours. And it's no joke. It's grueling. Mm-hmm. But it's a great experience. I've done it twice. Yeah. I'm trying to get back into class. My schedule is all jacked up and I can't, but I'm going to get back in there
for sure.
Next month.
For sure.
So if you are in the Atlanta area, you might want to check that out. Drop that URL or where can they find you?
Absolutely.
Facebook?
Yep. You can hit me up on Instagram at M-A-I-F, the number 8, and H, which basically stands for Make a Film in 8 Hours.
Yes. Don't forget to touch on your audition.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of people out here that need that service.
Absolutely. And if you're an actor and you're looking to get tape put on tape professionally, you can hit me up at Instagram as well. Spelled this way, AWEDITIONS, auditions. And you check us out. We do reels. We do self-taping. We do short scenes. Anything that deals with a camera, we do it.
Professionally. And it comes with some knowledge, too. He'll give you some tips. If you ask for it.
Absolutely, yeah.
He gets people booked, yeah. So, yeah. Telling you, don't sleep. This is his studio we're standing in right now. Mm-hmm. Fully facilitated. I'm talking about high-tech, state-of-the-art. He got some stuff in here. All right, so let's get into this camera work. So, yeah. I want to know, first and foremost, where did you come from? Because you didn't come from this.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so, when I first started out, there's growth here. This is my number one right here, all right? When I first started learning about self-taping, it was crazy. I was using this Casio digital lens. But you got to start somewhere,
you
right?
Start somewhere.
Everything comes from something, right?
Yeah.
And then I realized, you know what? This wasn't cutting it. I realized I needed an external microphone. But like I said, this is where you start from.
Okay.
So from that point, I end up going to a T4i, which was a Canon. Now, I started using Canons because my best friend of mine, he had a Canon, and I just loved the way it looked. And it was very user-friendly,
yeah.
You know, very user-friendly.
Yeah.
So I started with the T4i,
okay.
The Rebel, and it was really good. And I actually started doing my self-tapings with that.
Okay.
I then started to learn more about the process of speed and as far as the quality. So I would look at my tapes or short films I did and go, why doesn't mine look like, you know, something on big screen?
And that was all self-taught?
And that was all self-taught.
Okay.
All self-taught. So I'm just, you know, just playing around my camera, just shooting everything. You're shooting skits. You've seen some of my skits that I shoot.
Yeah, I've participated in some of your reels. So, yeah.
Absolutely. And from that, you know, I just was just learning because I was really thirsty to have my stuff look cinematic.
Okay.
Then I started learning about lenses. Lenses is extremely important.
That's
right?
The key. That's like key. Apps on your cell phone.
Seriously. Your lens game gotta be straight. So I'm gonna tell you right now, you can have a T4i or a Nikon. Now let me just say real quick about the Canons. Canons, well, I prefer Canons over Nikons. Nikons are really geared towards photographers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I do a lot of cinematography.
Okay.
And so I choose to do Canons because you can do a lot of in-camera settings as far as like picture styles, as far as color grading. If you don't want to do a lot of color grading in editing, do the color grading in the Canon. It's really good.
Wow.
Color is really good in the Canon versus a Nikon. I'm just saying, I'm going to keep it 100. Nikons are good for photography, but when you do that videography, the Canons, the color pops.
I learned the hard way. I had a Nikon.
Yeah.
It just wasn't cutting it.
It wasn't cutting. So Canons are really good for that. But at the end of the day, it's all about your preference, you know, so I'm going to say that. So this actually ended up being my third camera. This is a 7D right here. This is real good. It's a real chunk of metal, and it's heavy.
It's a big boy right
here. Yeah, it's a big boy, you know.
What lens do you have on there?
Now, I got the 50 millimeter on here, the 1.2.
Okay. All right.
Got the 50 millimeter. This is probably...
Those that don't know, is that short range, long range,
This is a problem because you pretty much have two type of lenses, major type of lenses, and you got your prime lens and then you got your zoom lens.
Okay.
This is a prime lens. You gotta have a real good prime lens when you do anything. So this prime lens, now you get a 50 millimeter that can cost you about $125. Mm. Or you can get one that's a big boy like this that costs about $1,700. Now trust me when I tell you,
the
difference.
You see the difference though.
You'll see the difference
what you get, right?
In the quality. You get what you pay for.
Yeah.
And so when I had my $125 lens, which is pretty much right here, I had this boy right here. This is my first 50 millimeter. It's good. You can tell the difference. You can tell the difference of richer and quality. You know, so I got the big boy right here, and it's just a world of difference. Moving on from that.
So before we move on, what is your favorite feature about this one? Do you use this a lot now,
or do you kind of
go back and forth?
So this is what I call my running gun. It's light. You know, you can pick it up, shoot anything. I use this a lot when I'm doing some running gun scenes. If I want to shoot something really quick, I can stuff it in my bag. It's really good for that. You know, when you're doing something that you're doing a lot of movement on, this is light. Also, I have a gimbal, and this is light enough to go on. This camera's probably about 7 pounds.
Okay.
You know,
so it won't topple over or anything like that. Can I put my hands on it?
Absolutely. So that's the queen right there. That's the queen camera right there.
Look at this.
It's a really cool, really, really dope lens. Now, that's a crop sensor, meaning that no matter, you know, because you got crop sensor cameras and then you got full frame cameras.
Okay.
The difference is that with this one, you put a lens on that, it's going to crop, as what it says, it's going to crop the framing.
All right.
But you put that same lens on a different full frame camera, which I'm going to show you a little bit later, it's a bigger range. You see a bigger picture.
Okay,
so full frame cameras usually cost a little bit more.
I did not know.
So but the good feature about this, like I said, it's light, it's durable, you know, it's smaller. And what happens is that you know, I can put this on a gimbal, it's about 7 pounds, maybe total of 10 once you have a heavy lens on it.
Okay.
And you can, you know, wheel and deal with it. So that's the best feature for this one, I would say.
All right.
Then I got
I had to step my game up,
and this is my granddaddy right here. This is my monster. This is what I call my monster. This camera right here, this is the 1D. This is the flagship of the Canons, right? This is the flagship of Canons right here. And this big boy right here I use for when I'm doing my short films, when I'm doing heavy-duty films, if I'm working on somebody else's film or I'm working on my own film, the quality is immaculate.
That thing looks like quality.
It's immaculate. Now, I also shoot headshots, and this right here, this is an 85 millimeter. This 85 millimeter runs almost about $2,000. Sigma. Everybody know about the Sigma game?
I got a Sigma. It ain't cost no $2,000, but I got a Sigma.
This lens. So you take this lens mixed with this camera's processor, it's the real deal, Holyfield. It's no joke.
God,
you know what I'm saying? And the shutter speed that's on this bad boy, this camera right here is just immaculate, you know. A lot of different functions. See that right there?
Yeah, that sounds like a gun.
It's ridiculous. So
that's
what you're
shooting
paying
off.
For. That's just shooting off. That's what shooting off.
Headshots. Hitting them.
Mm-hmm.
Dang.
So you're getting a quicker processor. This can shoot. You can shoot 4K in this as well.
Okay.
Versus, you know, my 7D, you can't.
All right.
The 1D, you can shoot 4K. So it's a granddaddy I use.
So how far off in quality is this from the Red Dragon and the Black Magic one?
Not that far, you know.
Those are some big boys.
Yeah, those are some big boys. Again, it's all gonna be in your lens.
All
because you can get cinematically, you can get the quality. I'm gonna tell you like this. If you was to have this 1D and you have a lens that's probably like say $2,500, right? And you compare it to a Red, you do some color grading, same look.
Color grading within the camera settings?
You can
or
get
in post?
In post.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You get the same quality. Because a lot of that, what you see that's shot in Red, a lot of it, when
it's
you
post.
See the file, yeah, you it's see it
just
was having post.
Okay.
Post is where the magic happens at, so you just gotta get really good at that.
And can you, I know, because like my camera,
nothing close to this. It is a Canon, nothing close to this. But I can do plugins, all types of stuff.
Yeah.
Put it, connect it online, do plugins.
You do all that. Everything that you could possibly imagine. You know, this camera costs $2,000, and anything you could possibly imagine, you could do with this camera. Now, the downside, if you want to say, if you will, is that you can't put this on a gimbal, the gimbal that I have, because it's just too heavy. This camera is about 11 pounds without the lens. It's 11 pounds,
wow.
Okay? And so then with this lens right here, you know, this is almost 16 pounds with this lens on it. So, but this is
a baby.
Yeah. So, but this is full sensor. The battery life on his Immaculate versus my 70, each battery gives me about maybe 2.5, maybe 3 hours if I'm lucky, depending on shooting. With this, for each battery, I'm getting at least 5 hours. And that's a big deal when you're working on the set. So, well, I got one charge and I can come back 5 hours, shoot this. So I very rarely run out of battery when I'm using this. So this is a Immaculate camera.
That's a monster.
I've had this camera not even a year, and it has not disappointed me.
And
the other quality is you can't use a SD card with this one. This uses what we call two things: a compact fast card and a C fast card. Compact fast card is when you want to shoot in 4K, and C fast is when you're shooting like, you know, HD or whatever.
And you can have both in there at the same time.
You can have both at
the
same time. You can have that both at the same time. This camera's a monster.
It's a monster.
So, very happy with this purchase. But this is something that I purchased after learning. Like I said, starting with the one joint. You know, I had to grow out of this and then go into the Rebel and then go into the 7D. And you start to grow out things. So it's not, don't just get something, you know, don't just go out and buy a Red because it's a Red. You gotta know how it functions.
Know how to work it.
Because otherwise you'll have a camera that is collecting dust because you don't know how to work it.
Okay, yeah.
Grow out of your supplies before you get to the next level.
So someone wanting to get into using cameras, you would recommend that they start small.
Absolutely.
Get something intermediate or beginner.
Get a Rebel.
Get a
you know, anywhere from a T2i to a T, you know, 7i, I think they got. Get a Rebel, good camera, get a nice lens. You start off with that. When you get to the point that you're growing out of it, then that's when you take it to the next level. You know, because it took me a couple of years to get to this point.
Okay.
It's a lot of learning. It's still a lot of functions on here that I don't know.
And remember, he's self-taught. And if you want to educate yourself, you can always go to websites like Udemy.com.
Mm-hmm.
So many classes on there. You can pay like $9 and learn anything. So don't sleep on it. Get on your job. You could be holding one of these big boys one day, you know? But like you said, don't get it just to get it. Know what you're doing with it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So anybody who's wanting to get in, like, what would be, like, the best advice you can give them just starting out?
Yeah. So I'm going
to... As far as, like, what's the first aspect of the camera or shooting that they should learn, whether it be taking headshots, photos, or filming?
I would definitely say, you know, you get a camera, like you get an inexpensive camera. You can get a camera that's under $500 to start off with. You know, your whole setup may cost you $750. That's with the lens, tripod, and all that good stuff. And then just go out and just shoot. Just shoot a couple things. Shoot some skits, you know. You and your friend, shoot some skits so you can start to learn how to do, you know, picture profiles, color grade in the camera.
Mm-hmm.
So you can learn those different things. And then once you start to really learn your camera, you got to really know your equipment. And that's the one advice I would give you is you get your equipment, know the ins and outs of it. Know it and know it well.
Cool. So would you say that's your prized possession right there?
This is my prized possession.
That's number
right
one.
Here. I use this anytime that I get a chance. I'm still learning. And I shoot a lot with this because I want to make sure that, one, that I'm getting my bang for my buck. I paid a lot for it, so I want to make sure I use it. Yeah.
Okay. So what other type of accessories do you have that work in conjunction with that? Because I know you got the mics.
Absolutely.
You got the boom mic. You got Tascam.
When I first got into this, I was like, why do so many people have different cameras and stuff like that? And depending on what you're shooting, your repertoire will grow. So, yeah, I mean, I have, you know, from the simple microphone up here, which is an NKG microphone, it costs maybe $100,
mm-hmm.
to a Rode microphone that I have that's a NTG 4 Plus that runs about $600. And you can tell I'm sounding quality. But, you know, it's to your preference. It's to your preference.
Okay.
Start small with a $100 microphone when you learn a lot of it. And you grow.
And then, like him, you can become an entrepreneur because you got the skill set and you can make this stuff pay for itself.
Yep.
Right?
Absolutely.
So we're talking big, high-priced dollar equipment here, But if you start a business with it and you render services, it could pay for itself.
Absolutely.
Plain and simple.
Yeah, just have fun. Have fun. That's what I saw. I just started having fun and people started coming to me and that's what it is. But so it's, it allows me to have fun when I'm not acting.
Right. Cool, cool. Cool. So what would be your next big purchase?
My next big purchase will be, you know, I don't know. I'm not sure yet. I just kind of let it go, you know. I may get a slider, a track slider, something like that. Maybe I'll try to see if I can find, probably a drone. You gotta do
the aerial shots.
Gotta do the drone.
That takes it to the next level.
Because right now I'm doing my aerial shots.
Hold it up.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah, holding that baby up there.
Exactly. So yeah, probably a drone.
God, okay. Cool. What else you got over here, man? I know you got some other little goodies over here. What's up with the task cam? Is that a task cam right there?
Yeah, so yeah, this is the task cam.
Got one over there, one here.
Got this task cam. This is actually the H6N. I have an H4N, an H5N, and an H6N. And pretty much these are good. You know, I'm not a boom operator, but you want to make sure you have good sound. And so, if you know, for under $200, not this one. This one costs probably $300. For under $200, you get an H4N that they have right now.
So, and why do you have so many? Is it just because you kept upgrading, or?
Yeah. Well, one, I kept upgrading, but I got the H4N because it was inexpensive. But I realized that the preamp, and that's basically your ability to hear, like, outside noise and stuff like that.
Okay.
It's a bit loud, noisy on H4N, so then I went to the H5N. Mm-hmm. And so on and so forth. As you go up, it goes up, you get a better quality.
Okay.
And in this one, you could put up to 6 microphones up on it. So it's just it's one of those things.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And what about, was it the little lapel mic you got?
I have those are on the side. But Sennheisers, and I got some Komikas that are really dope. They're dual. There's tons of stuff that's out there that you can get. But yeah, I shoot a lot of things. I'm a one man band, as you know.
Right, yeah.
And I needed some things where I can function and not have, you know, I couldn't afford a boom operator. So I got the wireless mics, you know, and I got those different things. So, and then when I do have a boom operator, then I have a boom pole, a separate boom pole that I can have. The boom poles are going to be your best sounds. The lapels is a good backup when you running and gunning and you got somebody that's far, you're trying to get a far away shot and you can't get the boom in the shot. You don't want to get the boom shot, so you do the lapels.
Okay.
But your best sound is going to come from a boom.
So last but not least, let's talk about the tripod. Because I know we discussed about a tripod before. Yeah. You said you kept going through tripods, it kept breaking.
Man.
And a lot of people don't think about a good tripod.
Yeah.
But it makes a difference to spend a little bit more money.
Well, if you got a big camera like this, you can't have no rink-a-ding tripod.
Right. Yeah. You can't put that
this
at risk.
It's probably my 6th tripod. Because when I was starting out, I was being cheap. And I was getting, you know, some tripods from Target, didn't do the service. And then I realized that I had to spend. So this tripod right here, it probably cost me almost $500.
Okay.
The other thing is that a lot of people that I tape, they're like 6 feet, 6'6", stuff like that. A lot of tripods, you got to make sure you find out the height.
Okay.
Because most of them, they average around 5 feet.
Yeah.
So I had to make sure that I get that. Yes, you definitely want to do that.
Can we drag it over into the
chat
a little bit?
Absolutely.
Let's show a little bit of this. I don't know if you can tell the quality of this, but this thing is a monster.
Yeah,
look at this.
And this one can handle several pounds, especially this big camera right here with the lens on it.
Wow.
You want to make sure that you have a good standard tripod that's sturdy. This tripod goes up to probably about 9 feet.
Okay.
So it's a beast.
So you can almost get somewhat kind of an aerial with it a little bit.
And then I got a different tripod when I do photography. You know, it just has a single head. Yeah.
Right.
So. You know,
and this is Benro.
Benro is an excellent. Like I said, it's preference, but Benro is good quality. It's gonna cost you a little bit more, but it's gonna last one. I've had this for over a year, no problems. Issues. I had some other ones that were under a year. It was just weak,
little
things were. So you learn. It's a learning curve.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, but yeah, other than that's probably definitely my. And then of course I got my light game and all that good stuff going on. My keto flows and all that.
Okay.
But go out there and just play, explore, you know, buy some equipment, outgrow it, go to the next level, have fun doing it, be creative,
yeah,
you know, and then you'll find out, make mistakes, break your equipment, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, it's a learning process.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Cool.
Man, I appreciate you coming on the show, being very informative.
Absolutely.
That's what this show is about, just bringing new tech, new thoughts and ideas. to the viewers, showing them some things they may have and they need to know some knowledge on it, or some things that they, you know, they got in mind and they want to know a little bit more before they make the purchase.
Absolutely.
So if you're looking for that, you're gonna drop a tag, but get your business up with it and go educate yourself.
There it is.
Show me your tech. And we're out.
Going to the moon. Going to the moon. And I see spaceships and rockets. Gold heart shaped lockets. I'm the plug in a socket. Girl, you know you got me.